Hello everyone, welcome to the lecture series on VLSI design. Myself Professor Meenakshi Torse, Department of ECE, KLS VDIT, Haryana. The previous lecture we discussed implementation of ALU functions using an adder element. We implemented adder circuit and then we discussed Manchester carry chain. So in this lecture we will be studying adder enhancement techniques. First, we study a ripple carry adder, carry select adder, carry skip adder, and then finally we'll end this lecture with the carry look ahead adder. So the first adder architecture is a 4-bit ripple carry adder. Ripple carry adder has a finite delay in obtaining the final output as carry has to be propagated from one stage to the other stage. In normal adder of 4 to 8 bits, this delay is insignificant. But a delay becomes prominent in case of 64 or 128 bit adders. So to increase speed of adders, faster carry generation techniques are made use of. These techniques improve speed of adder but increase the chip area. So 4 bit A and 4 bit B are applied parallelly, but to generate the final sum and carry, the carry has to be propagated to the succeeding stages. So to overcome this propagation delay, we'll use the faster carry generation techniques. So carry select adder. In this method, adder is divided into blocks and each block comprises of two adder cells. These adder cells are given with Cin as 1 and Cin as 0. Assuming these Cin values, the corresponding sum and carry output are computed, out of which correct sum bit and carry bit is selected by the MUX, for which the control signal is the carry in signal of a previous block. In this way, speed of next block is not dependent on the previous block. Now the speed of the adder only depends on this MUX circuit. Let me summarize. So carry select adder is divided into blocks. Each block consists of two adder elements with Cin as 1, Cin as 0. Sum and carry are computed for both the blocks, out of which one of the correct sum and carry is selected by a MUX. Hence speed of adder now only depends on MUX and the propagation of carry is eliminated, which improves the speed of adder but increases the chip area. The next adder architecture is carry skip adder, that is CSA. This adder makes use of a special block known as block propagation signal, which is used to detect whether the bits of operands A and B are different or same in all the positions. So this adder makes use of a block propagate signal. In a block, if the operands of A and B are different in all positions with respect to each other, then the carry does not get generated. For example, consider A as 0110 1011 and B as 1001 0100. So if you compute the sum, you can observe that the Cout is not generated. So from this example, we can conclude that if A and B are different in all positions, then the carry does not get. Hence, in such cases, carry need not get propagated at all. Thus, to save this propagation time, a special signal called a block propagation is used. Carry skip adder is divided into blocks. For each block, a special circuit is used to detect if the bits of the operand A and B are different or are same in all positions with respect to each other. So this special block is nothing but it performs an XOR operation of operand A and operand B. If the output signal from this special block is 1, then the carry signal entering the block can bypass it and can be transmitted to the next stage through the mux. If the block signal is 1, it means there is no carry generated, and if the block propagation signal is 0, it indicates a carry is generated. So let me summarize. A special circuit known as block propagation is used to detect if the operands of A and B are same or different. This special block is known as block propagation signal. So this block propagation signal performs XOR between A and B. If the output of block propagation signal is 1, it indicates there can be no generation of carry, and hence the carry input can be bypassed and fed to next stage via mux. And if block propagation is 0, it indicates that there is a generation of carry, and hence the input carry gets propagated through the blocks. So thus propagation delay in this block gets avoided and the speed of adder gets improved compared to ripple carry adder. So before moving to carry look ahead adder, so let us first understand what is generate, propagate and kill concept that is required for carry look ahead adder. So to understand generate, propagate and kill concept, consider a 1 bit full adder with inputs A, B, C in, output sum and C out. You are familiar with the truth table. For the following A, B, C in values, these are the C out and sum values we get. So if A and B are 0, it means the carry does not get generated, or we can say the carry gets deleted or the carry is killed. And if A is 0 and B is 1, the carry input is propagated to C out. You can observe from the truth table, carry input 01 is getting propagated to C out when A is alternating values, that is A0, B1, A1, B0. So for these combinations, the carry input gets propagated. And when A is 1 and B is 1, we say a carry gets generated. So when A is 0, B is 1, and when A is 1, B is 0, for these alternating combination, carry gets propagated . So based on this, we can write one more truth table with A, B, C in inputs, generate, propagate, kill signal, C out and sum. So when A is 0, B is 0, there is no generation of carry. It means carry is deleted or carry gets killed. So kill signal is 1, whereas generate and propagate are 0. When A is alternating 0 1 1 0 combination, carry gets propagated. So propagate signal is 1, whereas generate and kill are 0. And when A is 1, B is 1, carry is getting generated. You can observe carry gets generated. So generate is 1, whereas propagate and kill are 0. So from this table, we can conclude that generate, propagate and kill are mutually exclusive. That is, among generate, propagate and kill variable, only one variable can be at logic 1 at a time. So from this table, we can write generate is 1 when A is 1, B is 1. It means the expression for generate is AB. And when generate is 1, carry gets generated. So Cout is 1. And when A is 0, B is 0, there is no generation of carry. That is, carry gets deleted or killed. So A is 0, B is 0. Expression can be written as A bar, B bar. So when kill is 1, there is no generation of carry, so Cout is 0. And when AB values are 0, 1 or 1, 0, the carry is getting propagated. So 0, 1, 1, 0. So A bar B plus AB bar. So this is nothing but A XOR B. So when propagate is 1, carry depends on seen value. Carry is exactly equal to seen. You can observe when propagate is 1, C out is exactly equal to seen value. For full adder, some expression is given as A XOR B XOR seen. A XOR B is nothing but propagate signal. So the expression for sum is P XOR seen, where P is propagate signal. And the expression for C out is AB plus A XOR B into seen. AB is nothing but generate signal. A XOR B is propagate signal. So C out expression is G plus P into seen. So from these expressions, we can extend it for 4-bit adder. So in general, C out expression can be written as CI equals to GI plus PI into CI minus 1. So 4-bit adder will have 3 carry output variables, C0, C1, C2, C3. So C0 equals to G0 plus P0. CI minus 1 for first stage is the carry input seen. C1 is G1 plus P0 into C0. Substituting C0, C1 expression will be only in terms of seen. Similarly, C2 is G2 plus P2 C1. Substitute C1 and simplify. This entire term will be getting it in seen. C3 is G3 plus P3 C2. Substitute to C2 and simplify. So with these generate, propagate and kill concept, study carry look ahead adder, that is 4-bit carry look ahead adder. So in ripple carry adder, final carry output cannot be obtained without the propagation of carry in through the previous adder cells. Hence, using generate and propagate functions, this propagation of carry can be avoided and carry outputs can be computed directly, and hence the speed of the adder can be improved, but at the cost of increased chip area. So as discussed in the previous slide, so carry expression is C0 equals to G0 plus P0 seen. You can observe C0 depends only on a seen. C1 is G1 plus P1 C0. So if you substitute C0, C1 is G1 plus P1 G0 plus P1 P0 seen. So C1 is depending only on the carry input, whereas it is not depending on the previous carry C0. Similarly, these are the expressions for C2 and C3. C3. So all the carry outputs for a 4-bit adder are computed directly without dependency, as there is no ripple effect and speed of the adder is increased. But the limitation with carry lookahead adder is the expression of carry outputs becomes large and hence logic becomes quite large. So based on the carry expression, the circuit for C3 can be implemented as follows. A CMOS circuit, that is NMOS and PMOS, which is a mirror circuit or a symmetric circuit. So NMOS G3 is parallel with P3 G2, parallel with P3 P2 G1 in series, parallel with series combination of P3 P2 P1 G0, parallel with P3 P2 P1 P0 seen. So G3, you can observe here G3 is in parallel with P3 and G2. These two terms are in parallel with P3, P2, G1. This term is in parallel with P3, P2, P1, G0. This third term of C3 is in parallel with P3, P2, P1, P0, C. So the pull-up section is exactly opposite of pull-down. So the structure implemented in the previous slide is a static one. This one is a dynamic one with the insertion of a clock signal.